So I am going to give a small overview of the research we do in our team. This is an applied research, not theoretical, but we solve applied optimization problems. And first, I will speak about classical optimization problems, which are usually solved by exact algorithms. And these are maximum click problem, vertex coloring problem, big clustering problem, single machine scheduling problems. And the classical approach we use and that I used in the state of art papers are dynamic programming and branch and bound methods, and also mathematical models, which are usually solved with some solvers like general purpose solvers like Cplex or Baron. In branch and bound algorithms, there are such parts very important as filtering techniques, branching strategy, and bounds. For bounds, we usually use some relaxations of the problem. For example, the simplest is the linear programming relaxation. Other bounds are some theoretical estimations of the objective function value, and there can be also some algorithmic estimations which allow us to prune branches of the search tree, reducing the search, reducing the number of nodes considerably. Okay, let's continue. Here is an example just for the maximum click problem. We want to find a complete subgraph of maximum size. Here we can see different clicks. For example, here is 4, size here is 5. But the maximum click is in the center, it has 6 vertices. In big graph, it is not easy to find maximum click, or in other words, we can say that we want to find some cluster of the maximum size or part of our network, which is completely connected, which has the largest size. For these problems, we have several approaches published in different papers, and they are connected with branch and bound algorithm and different pruning techniques, and also the selecting of branches during the search, which is also important for reducing the computational time. Next is the problem which we also worked a little bit is vertex coloring problem, or another equivalent problem is click partitioning. You want to partition to the minimum number of clicks. When we say about coloring problems, we want to partition to the minimum number of independent sets where vertices are not connected. But we can reformulate it as the click partitioning where vertices are connected. So here is an example for click partitioning. Here we have 6 clicks, 5 clicks, I think 6 5 clicks with 3 vertices and 1 small click with 1 vertex, for example, in this. For this problem, we developed a heuristic based on bitwise operations, which is very efficient in modern computers because it uses bitwise operations, and in one operation we process 64 vertices and 64-bit architecture. Next problem we considered is big clustering problems and particular cell formation problem, or also gene expression data mining, which is also can be described in these terms. You are given a matrix with zeros and ones, and you want to partition. You want to partition these ones both by rows and by columns. You want to group both rows and columns simultaneously. That is why it is called big clustering, because we cluster rows and columns in one group, in several groups. And you actually want to make this matrix as much block diagonal as possible by grouping rows and columns together. You can move rows and columns and group them like this. You see here we grouped first 6 and other columns and these rows. And we see here good clustering, except these voids. These are called voids, zeros. This is almost almost ideal cluster. This is used, for example, in gene expression data mining. When you want to here, for example, you see some genes, and here you see some conditions in which these genes are involved when they work, for example, and you have these ones showing that this gene is activated in some conditions. Conditions are, can be in environment, individual, or some tissues of individual. And they group it and see that in these conditions, these genes are activated. This is very popular in biological science. So this is actually a hard combinatorial optimization problem, and we have some, here is, you can see, big matrix, and here is the solution. And we have actually exact model for this problem, which works good for not very large problems, and we have a good heuristics also, heuristics for large problems. Next single machine scheduling problem, we considered this kind of problem, preemptive single machine scheduling problem of minimizing total weighted completion time. So you have jobs, you have one processor, each job has its weight, you want to minimize the total weighted completion time, and also you have preemptions, which means that the job can be interrupted in favor of another job, and also you have you have arbitrary release dates and processing times of these jobs. These are classical single machine scheduling problem. We have developed a fast heuristic for it, and also some lower and upper bounds which can be further used in exact search. Next, our main part of our research is applied optimization problems, which are track and trailer routing problems, warehouse optimization problems, and flexible job shop scheduling problems. So what are the features or properties of these problems, and what are the approaches? The problem is that these problems have big number of variables, parameters, and constraints, and it is usually impossible to find an exact solution. And even it is hard to find just a feasible solution, it is usually also hard. And this is why special approaches are needed for this kind of problems. Exact ones cannot work here because of large search space, huge. And that is why very popular are local search heuristics, but the problem for local search is that you should start with some feasible solution in classical approach. And it is difficult to find. There are some greedy heuristics, but for very hard constraint problems, it is difficult to find even a feasible. In this case, you can start from infeasible solution, but use penalties for infeasibilities. You can just modify your objective function value if you have some infeasibilities, and then try with local search to remove these infeasibilities. The problem with this approach is that after you get into a feasible solution, it is difficult to go out of it, because the local search cannot make steps, because every time it changes something in the solution, it gets infeasible. And infeasible has a big penalty. That is why a very good approach is to combine these penalties with taboo search. Taboo allows you to go from one solution to a worse solution. In this case, you can have big penalties, and you can go even to worse solutions, but then the taboo search has such a nature that it will remove these infeasibilities one by one, jumping from feasible to infeasible solution and vice versa. And this is a very good combination for such a large problems with big number of constraints. First, we considered vehicle routing problem, but with truck and trailers, I'll show. In classical vehicle routing problems, you have, for example, here you have three vehicles, and they should serve these customers with their demands. They all have demands shown with red numbers, but doesn't matter. And a vehicle has limited capacity. So here you have three vehicles and such a kind of routes. Here is a solution, like just a solution is shown. But when you have truck and trailers, some of the customers can be served with a trailer because it is a small store, for example, in some narrow street in the city. And you can come drive to it only with a truck. So you have to leave your trailer somewhere. In this case, you have the following solution like this. You come with truck and trailer here. There you have to leave. Here you have to leave your trailer, and it is unloaded at this store, with this customer. And the truck goes alone here and serves these three so-called truck customers, which can be served only with the truck. And then truck comes back. Here is some problem with this arrow. Comes back to take a trailer, and then it goes back to the depot. And here also you have to leave your trailer two times. You leave here your trailer two times and comes back. And here also you leave your trailer once. So the truck and trailer routing problem is much more complicated. And also accept these demands and accept this complication, we have the following constraints. We have transshipment locations, which are locations where you can leave a trailer just for parking. You have site dependency, which means that not any vehicle can serve any customer. So you have for every customer you have a set of vehicles which can serve it. You have soft and hard time windows. Hard time windows like open and close time of the customer, and soft time windows is some kind of preferred time where they prefer for you to come and to deliver some goods. And also you have split deliveries, which means that one customer can be served by two vehicles. So two vehicles can drive to it and they can bring parts of the order to it. We have a paper in this conference. It was in Moscow for this problem. It was iterative greedy heuristics, but we also now developing taboo search heuristic with this penalties approach for this problem. Next problems we consider in our team is warehouse optimization problems. There are three kind of problems. First is optimization of routes of pickers who pick orders during the picking process. The travel times have a very large impact to the cost of warehouse activity. Next is optimization of occupied space, because if you put goods with no strategy, it is too much. It occupies too much space, and the space in the warehouse is usually very expensive. And optimization of storage location assignment. This is long time optimization when you optimize, when you have some statistics of goods coming in and out the warehouse, and you want to assign location to every product in such a way that you minimize the total cost in long term, in long time. The total cost of putting it to storage and putting it out. Here we also have paper heuristic that is connected with optimizing of occupied space. And flexible job shop scheduling, we just start considering it. It is a problem of optimizing manufacturing process when you have a lot of machines and a lot of parts to be processed on these machines in manufacturing process. And you have different types of machines, like casting machines, like machines with computer numerical control. And they have different speeds. So you have several casting machines, but with different speeds. You have several different computer numerical controlled machines. You have also preemptions as usual. So every job can be very long, but it can be preempted. For example, you need to make 1,000 of some kind of parts. But you can make, for example, only 100, then stop in favor of another job, and so on. You have orders, each order have due dates. You have release dates, when you can start this job. You have priorities of jobs. Different orders can be have different priorities. For you have, for example, some factory manufacturing, some parts. You have setup times, which means that after making one job, for example, casting, if you change the type of this job, you have to set up your machine. For example, you want to change how it is called, press form when you cast the press form. You change it, and it can be very long time, like 12 hours, because you need to cool it first. And here are the references which I already mentioned. So this is kind of overview of our research in classical and applied optimization problems we do in our team. And also I can say that we have two projects with commercial company implementing our solutions in practice. So that's all.
Thanks. So for some of these big models, do you have any feasibility issues?
Yeah. For example, for this truck and trailer routing problem, you have the problems, for example, with capacity of capacity when you don't have enough capacity to cover all the customers in time. You have time windows, that is why you have to be in time. And you have sometimes you need to have more trucks to be in time because you have time constraints. And if you take a lot of customers, the last one can be served in time. Also, with this side dependency, you have, for example, three types of vehicles. And if you assign one type of vehicle to wrong customer, I mean to a customer which can be served with another vehicles which you have a lot of, yeah. Sometimes you can make an infeasible solution because this type of vehicles, you used all of them, and there are some customers which can be served with other type of vehicles. So you should always...
The first issue is to solve the
there are actually a number of instances, real life ones we have, where it is difficult to find a feasible solution. So you have...
Yeah. Okay. Any questions from our team?
Yes. Okay. You described many problems.
Yeah.
Why you consider these problems and not another one? Are they the most...
Yeah, actually, routing and scheduling problems seem to be most challenging because a lot of papers are devoted to it, and also scheduling and routing, actually, they are everywhere. They are really a big part of real life. And other problems, like classical ones, we just considered in our team. Some of them, like maximum click or coloring, they are connected in some way with clustering because click is the largest cluster and with graph clustering, better to say. And coloring is click partition of the graph. So they are connected with our latest research with this grant, RSF project. And also they are usually these classical problems, we deal with them as a part of some large problem. Because, for example, in this routing problem, we have to deal with transportation problem when we assign vehicles to customers. So it is all connected.